administration, okay, in the southern kingdom. So what kind of administration was there in the southern kingdom? King was the supreme authority. Okay, who was the supreme authority? King. King was the powerful ruler. Okay, so king was having all the authority. All the power was in hand of king at that time. What happened? King, he was assisted in his work by council of ministers. This we did in the Chandragupta Maurya chapter also. That king was of supreme authority. All the power was in the hand of whom? All the power was in the hand of king. And he used to get assisted by the council of ministers. So what council of ministers do? Your council of ministers advise king on various matters. Okay. Your council of ministers, they advise the king, very good, Vanshika, on important matters. They give their advice. Like Modi ji is there. So there are council of ministers also, like health minister, finance minister, education minister. So those ministers give advice to what to prime minister on important matters. Similarly, king is having all the power. He's assisted by in his work by the council of minister, and council of minister used to advise the king on all the important matters. So king, what the king is doing? Beta, your king is collecting revenue. Revenue means the money, the tax. He used to collect it. He used to collect the revenue from where? From the farmers, from the merchants. Merchants means the traders. Okay. From the farmers, from the merchants, and from the craftsmen. From where the revenue used to come? From the farmers, from the merchants. Merchant means the traders who used to trade in some material or things, and the craftsmen. And the craftsmen. So this revenue, whatever the king is collecting, this revenue was used to maintain the army. Okay, whatever revenue the king was collecting, it was used to maintain the army of the king, the infantry. Underline the word infantry and write the meaning over there. Okay, whenever some word comes, I am explaining you the meaning, immediately take out your pencils, underline and write the meaning. Infantry means the foot soldiers, the soldiers on the foot. Those are known as infantry. Okay. Next is elephants were there in their army, and cavalry. Cavalry is the armed vehicle. Okay. Armed vehicle it is. So underline and write. Infantry means foot soldiers. Cavalry means armed vehicles. Yes, Adit, soldier on the horses, those are known as cavalry. They are armed with weapons. So next topic is about the trade. Very important topic about the trade. If I talk about the trade, the people of the Sangam age, means the Tamil age, the people used to trade with Rome, Greece, Africa, Sri Lanka, Southeast Asia. You can underline. The people of the Sangam age, they used to trade with Rome, Greece, Africa, Sri Lanka, and Southeast Asia. They used to generally trade with the Romans. Okay? They used to generally trade with the Romans or the people of the Western world. So Romans used to like the pearls of the Pandyan kingdom. They were very interested. Romans were very interested in the pearls of the Pandyan kingdom. So Pandyan kingdom used to export the pearls to the Romans. Gemstones, ivory. Gemstones, ivory, sandalwood, cotton, silk textile. These things were also traded. Ivory means the tusk or teeth of an animal. Ivory means the tusk or teeth of an animal. So the people of the Sangam literature, they used to export the gemstones, ivory, sandalwood, cotton to Greece and Rome. Where they used to export these things to Greece and Rome. So peacocks and monkeys were also exported. Means some birds and animals were also exported. So peacock and monkeys were also exported to the other parts of the country. Okay, to the other parts of the world. Teeth. Vedika, it's teeth. Southern kingdom. See, southern kingdom was very famous for spices. As you know, south kingdom is very famous for spices. Pepper. This pepper was in great demand in the Western world. Okay, this pepper, it was in great demand in the Western world. I told you, Romans, they used to take pearls from the Pandyan kingdom. So these Romans used to take pearls from the Pandyan kingdom and they used to pay for these items in gold. Other that was exported to these countries only, which we have talked about. Africa, Sri Lanka, Rome, Greece, Southeast Asia. So Southern Kingdom was very much famous for its spices and pepper was in great demand in the Western world. What happened? Romans used to pay for all these items in gold. Roman used to pay for all these items in gold. When they were paying in gold, what happened? The Southern Kingdom became rich because what? Whenever the Southern Kingdom is exporting something, what is coming to them? Gold is coming to them. So like this way, your Southern Kingdom, they became very much rich. Okay, your Southern Kingdom, they became very much rich. Next topic is about the religion. If I talk about the religion, your Tamils, ancient Tamils means the people of the Tamil in olden times, they were religious minded. They used to worship. Okay? They used to worship. Students, if you're not switching on your video, I'm going to remove right now. Within a second, switch on your video as soon as possible. I should not take anybody's name now. Otherwise, I will remove. Divyam Sharon. Switch it on. Hardik. Kirat. Moksh. Rishant. Uday. Sixth Awesome. And these four. Dhruv, Hiral, Rudra Kamboj, and Sachman. Your videos should be on. Connect yourself to audio also. Connect yourself to audio also. One by one, if I start removing, that will not be good. Dhruv, Hiral, Rudra. So yes, if I talk about religion, the ancient Tamils, they were very much religious minded. Okay, they used to worship mother goddess. They used to worship whom? They used to worship mother goddess. They used to worship Shiva, Vishnu, Brahma, Indra, Varuna. These were the gods they used to worship. Now, if I talk about the social life of your Sangam literature or your Sangam age people, social life, they were interested, means they were doing main occupation, agriculture, pearl fishing and weaving. This was their main occupation. Agriculture, pearl fishing and weaving. They were also doing some fine arts work, like they were interested in music, in dance, in drama and painting. They were also interested in all such things. So the Sangam age people, they were leading a very prosperous life. Agriculture, pearl fishing, and weaving. These were their main occupation. Fine arts like music, dance, drama, painting, these were also flourished in the time of Sangam age. Beta, they used to collect the pearls and they used to do fishing also, Karen. Because Roman were interested in pearls, na? They used to take out the pearls and they used to do the fishing also. So it is known as pearl fishing. They have given the name. Temple architecture means temple architecture also flourished in this period only during your Sangam age. Students, again, I will not give. If your screen is off, you are absent for me. I'm going to mark absent. I'm going to deduct your marks out of 20. I'm going to give zero whose videos are off. Nishant, Ronav, I'm watching you. Udainur. Dhruv, Rudra, Sachman. So what is the next topic? The next topic is about the North and the Deccan. What happened in the Northern side and in the Deccan side? The North and the Deccan. If I talk about the Satvahanas, they were also known as Andhras. They were also called Andhras, your Satvahanas. They used to rule nearly for 400 years, okay? These Satvahanas, they ruled nearly for 400 years. This Satvahana kingdom was founded by Simukha, underline in your books, Simukha in 235 BC. Satvahana's kingdom was founded by Simukha in 235 BC. His successor was Kana, underline. Because successor is a person who is given the throne after someone. Like Simukha was ruling, after Simukha, who will become the ruler? Kana. So his successor Kana, 212 to 195 BC, he ruled. Who founded the kingdom? Simukha founded the Satvahanas in 235 BC. And for 23 years, Simukha ruled over there. His successor was Kana. He came in 212 to 195 BC and he extended Simukha kingdom till Nasik. He extended the territory of Simukha kingdom till your Nasik. Nasik is a place in Maharashtra. Satakarni I. After that, who came? Satakarni I. He was probably the son of your Kunala. Okay, he ruled for only 2 years. The Satakarni I, he was son of Kunala and used to rule for only 2 years. He conquered the western Malwa. Okay, he conquered the western part of the Malwa plateau. This king, Satakarni I, he used to perform your Ashwamedha Yajna, that is horse sacrifice, and Rajasuya Yajna. Okay, Rajasuya Yajna is a plant or a juice kind of material which is given for offering while doing the Yajna. Yajna means Yajna. While doing the Yajna, it is Rajasuya means Raja used to offer some plant material or some fruits, vegetables to the Yajna. So that is Rajasuya Yajna. It is similar to your Ashwamedha Yajna. Satakarni I, they are saying that was probably a son of Kunala, that is the ruler only who was ruling at that time. It is the name of the ruler. His Satakarni I having two sons. One was Vedistri and Satasri. These were the two sons of your Satakarni I, Vedistri and Satasri. So after that, who came? After that came your Satakarni II. And he ruled from 166 to 111 BC. Okay. He ruled from 166 to 111 BC, and he also ruled Andhras only for 56 years. He ruled Andhra for about 56 years. Got this point? Till here, any doubters there, you may ask. Done? Okay. So after Satakarni II, the powerful ruler of this Satvahanas came. Kana was successor of Simukha. After Simukha, he became the ruler. Yes, Tashi, correct. Andhras means Andhra Pradesh at that time. The southern kingdom. Yes, Adit, you may ask while writing in the chat. Varun, you may ask while writing in the chat whatever doubt you are having. Beta, I'm telling you na, Kunala was a ruler only. Okay? They are saying Simukha was only known as Kunala. So his son was Satakarni I. Okay? Next, the most powerful ruler came. The most powerful ruler was your Gautami Putra, Sri Satakarni. Kindly underline it. What was the name? Gautami Putra Sri Satakarni was the powerful ruler. He was a very important ruler of that time. His mother name was Gautami Balashri. How we know about Gautama Putra Sri Satakarni? We came to know about Gautami Putra Sri Satakarni by an inscription composed by his mother. One inscription is there, composed by his mother, Gautami Balashri. We came to know about Gautami Putra Sri Satakarni. The Satvahana rulers, underline, your Satvahana rulers were known as the lords of Dakshinapatha, means the South Kingdom. Your Satvahana rulers, all the rulers, they were known as lords of Dakshinapatha, means these are ruling the Dakshin. Dakshin means South Kingdom. They are ruling the South Kingdom. And these rulers ruled about AD 70 to AD 95. This also underline. They ruled about AD 70 to AD 95. This your Gautami Putra Sri Satakarni, he overthrew Nahapana, the Saka chief, okay, 18th year of his rule. Reign means rule, rule over a country. So during Nahapana was ruling, he was the Sakha chief. During 18th year of his rule, he overthrew him. Who? Gautami Putra Sri Satakarni overthrew Nahapana, the Sakha chief, during the 18th year of his rule. After that, who came? After that, your Pulumai II came. Actually, your Gautami Putra Sri Satakarni was not only a warrior, but also he used to take active part in establishing peace in the empire. Gautami Putra Sri Satakarni was a powerful warrior. Okay. He also took active participation for maintaining peace in his empire. Okay. He want to bring change in the society. He want to bring some reform in the society. Reform means some changes. And he purged. P-U-R-G-E-D, purged means to get rid of the people. He want to get rid of the evils of the society. He don't want any evil practice to continue in his kingdom. Okay. What is overthrew? Overthrew means that the Gautami Putra Sri Satakarni, what he did, he became the ruler of that empire where Nahapana was ruling. Okay. He overthrew him and he became the ruler over there, over his kingdom. When you are overthrowing someone means in place of that person, now you are ruling. Now in place of Nahapana, he was ruling. Dakshinapatha means South India. Correct. Now Pulamai second king, okay, he succeeded Gautamiputra Satakarni. Okay, Pulamai expanded the South kingdom further. He was succeeded by Sri Satakarni. Okay, he was succeeded by Sri Satakarni and Rudraman. Rudradaman was his father-in-law. Pulamai second succeeded Gautamiputra Satakarni. Okay, he expanded empire further to south, means more empire he occupied. Pulamai second was succeeded by Sri Satakarni. His kingdom flourished more when Sri Satakarni came. And Sri Satakarni father-in-law name was Rudradaman. Sri Satakarni father-in-law name was Rudradaman. The last ruler of your this Satvahanas, underline, who was the last ruler? Last ruler was Yajna Satakarni. Who was the last ruler? The last ruler name is Yajna Satakarni. During his rule, Satvahanas regained some prosperity, but around the middle of the 3rd century, the dynasty came to an end. When Yajna Satakarni became the last ruler, their kingdom flourished. They regained some prosperity over that time. But around the middle of the 3rd century, their kingdom came to an end. Their empire broke down into small regional kingdoms. Okay, the Satvahanas were broken down into small regional kingdoms. This was all about your Satvahanas. Any doubt? You may ask, good, very good. You are so intelligent. Again, I'm telling. Okay. So, ma'am is going to ask you questions. Rudra Kamboj, Dhruv, your video is still off. Teeth, Sushant, Sukhsaj, Shaurya, Samarth, Sahaj, Preet, Rishant, Parth. But a ma'am is going to cut the marks, then don't blame me. Ma'am, why out of 20 I got 0? Kirat. Adit, they have told you about Rudradaman earlier, what used to be there. Earlier used two kingdoms, okay? They used to marry their daughter or their son with each other to have more control over other territory. So Rudradaman name came. He became the father-in-law. Means Sri Satakarni married his daughter. So his kingdom also came under his rule. Okay. So it is not given us. Sanvi, always the ruler name used to come. Okay, Mayak, no problem. Next topic is about the Kushanas. The Kushanas empire established in 1st century BC. Their kingdom flourished in your 1st century BC. Various people of your Kushanas were living around Gandhara and Bacteria. These are the name of the places. The Kushanas used to rule in the 1st century BC, and various people living around your Gandhara and bacteria were brought under King Cardassus. The people who were living here, they were brought under your king. Cardassus. As Chinese under the Han dynasty began to lose their hold over Central Asia. Okay. Chinese were losing their control in the Central Asia. Kushanas expanded their empire over there. Okay. Where the Chinese were ruling earlier. Okay. Their hold was becoming weak. There, your Kushanas empire expanded towards the east of the kingdom. Okay. So they only. Okay, along with the southern branch of Silk Route, they expanded their kingdom. Understood? Gunjan, check your network connection one time. So what happened? Again, I'm telling you about the Kushanas. Then I'm going to ask you questions. The Kushanas used to rule in the first century BC. Various peoples of your Gandhara and your Bacteria, okay, they used to brought together under King Cardassus. So earlier Chinese were ruling, okay? Chinese Han dynasty was there. They were ruling over the empire in the Central Asia. But your Kushanas, they expanded their kingdom towards the eastward along with the southern branch of Silk Route. At the time, now Northwest India was conquered by Kushanas. At that time, your Northwest was conquered by your Kushanas. Anu ma'am, am I audible? Bacteria, Kashi. It is earlier, it was a name of a place. Okay, yes. So they are saying what was happening at the same time. The Northwest India, at that time it was conquered by the Kushanas. The third king of the dynasty was King Kanishka. He is very what important ruler, underlined King Kanishka. There are pictures also in your book about him. So in third king of the dynasty was, name was King Kanishka. He was the one who promoted Buddhism. Beta ruler name Gunjan. Kushanas, like the Satvahanas, was the name of the dynasty. Kushanas also the name of the dynasty. They promoted what? Buddhism. Third king was King Kanishka. He promoted Buddhism throughout the country. Throughout his empire, he promoted Buddhism. During his period, he was one of the powerful empire. Okay, one of the powerful empire he established at that time. The extent of Kushana Empire ranked with those of Rome, Persia, and China. This person traded, Kanishka, he traded with Rome, Persia, and China. He built a very strong relationship with these countries. The empire owned much of the financial success of the Silk Route trade. Earlier I told you, he came from the southern branch of Silk Route. So they used to do the Silk Route trade at that time. trade flourished in his empire and he did cultural exchange also. I told you, he was in good relation with Rome, Persia and China. So they exchanged their cultures also, these countries, through the Silk Route only. Through the Silk Route, they exchanged their culture also. It is not known when Buddhism came to China. It is not known when the Buddhism went to China. Its stability provided by the Kushana Empire, because Kushana Empire were the one who promoted Buddhism in many parts of the world. So Kushana Empire was having trade relations with China. So they are saying this can be said that Kushana Empire promoted Buddhism in China. Buddhist text traveled to eastward of China through Kushana Empire only. Through Kushana Empire, this Buddhist text reached to China. They traveled eastward to China. So understood this? Beta Divyam, I am audible. Kindly check your network connection. Tomorrow I'll give you one brief of Kushana Empire once again. So let me ask you a few questions.